Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, today we are starting the introduction to computers last chapter, part A. This chapter is about understanding the needs for security measures. You know, you have understood the importance of the computers. You have understood the importance of data inside computers, and you have understood the importance of this technology. Now, we need to understand the security about these computers and their data. You know, the computer contents and computer itself are very important to everyone, either for organization, either for individual, in for the government. So if we need to, safeguard our computers and its valuable information or contents. Now imagine if someone stores your information, your financial record, your school works, your personal correspondence, your secret governmental data, then what would be happen if they change it, our data is changed, it is destroyed or made public? So this will be a very huge loss. So in order to safeguard our data, in order to safeguard our hardware, in order to safeguard our computer software, we need to take some security measures. But before understanding to take some security measures, we need to understand what are the possible threats to computers and its contents. So it's important security, like in real life, it's important to take security measures into the cyber world or into the computer world. You know, nowadays, if you, even in the real life, agar kisi ki gaadi hai, तो हम उसको लॉक करते हैं, इंश्योरेंस करते हैं और सिक्योर जगह पे उसको गैरेज में खड़ा करते हैं। इसी तरह से एक गाड़ी से ज़्यादा कंप्यूटर भी इम्पॉर्टेंट है। अगर कंप्यूटर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से रिलेटेड है तो कितने बिलियंस ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स होते हैं। अगर कंप्यूटर गवर्नमेंट के हवाले से रिकॉर्ड है, कीप करता है, तो गवर्नमेंट की कितनी इम्पॉर्टेंट डेटा होती है। इसी तरह से किसी इंडिविजुअल की पर्सनल इंफॉर्मेशन, तो हमें कंप्यूटर को सिक्योर करना है। सिक्योरिटी को समझने के से पहले हमें ये समझना होगा कि इससे पॉसिबल प्रॉब्लम्स हैं या थ्रेट्स हैं कंप्यूटर को और हमारे डेटा को। तो आप अंदाजा कर सकते हैं कि दीज आर सम ऑफ द टाइप्स ऑफ द सिक्योरिटी मेजर्स। दिस कैन बी इंटरनेट एंड नेटवर्क अटैक्स, सम ऑफ द हैकर्स अटैक ऑन द सिस्टम एंड सम ऑफ द वायरसेस सेंड सम वायरसेस सम सेंड दे entered into our system and steal information. Some unauthorized access to use, like people intercepting our wireless communication, somehow we somehow in wireless or wired communication, some unauthorized access and use by someone which is not related to the us, like hardware theft, our laptops, smartphones, or somehow the desktops which we stole from the office or from the home or somewhere from the way. Like these, like system failure, sometimes the light issues, then this can system can fail, hardware can be burned. So natural disasters, so these are the some issues, security issues, the real issues. Information theft, someone may take the our data, copy from our system, someone take legal copying through USBs or through network entry. So these are the security threats, clear-cut security threats which can happen to anyone, to the organization, to the private or public or to the individuals. So we perform online transactions, we perform our online social media network, social use social media. We have individually as well as inside organization, there are lots of use, and these are some of the security risks that can be happening to any computer. So if we understand these risks, then we can understand how to take security measures. You see now threats, security and threats. Now if we understand that some of the threats are something that can harm our computer. And the security are the countermeasures that we take in order to attempt to neutralize the threats by taking some countermeasures. So harms can be, previous slide I told you about the hardware software theft, data theft, privacy, loss, all of these things can happen. So these are the things that can happen on the and when our computers are especially connected to the network and online world. The basic security concept is the level of potential damage or is the countermeasures from the harm. The harm is actually level of potential damage. It includes all the parts, especially related to data loss, related to privacy loss, related to inability to use hardware. Sometimes hardware is sick. We are unable to use it. Sometimes software is unable to use it because of some uninvited bugs or hardware. So these are the things that can happen. So countermeasures, we need to take some steps to block these threats. Protect data from theft, protect system from theft. Now, theft, we can place the hardware into the secure place. We can make hardware, software security strong so that we can protect the theft. So, but there are some thefts which we need to understand. What type of the threats are there? There are identity theft. Some person may replace some of the genuine person and said, like the imposition by private information. Thief can become the victim. The person can come inside the system and on behalf of some of the employee, on behalf of some of the friend, or on behalf of this fake account, representing some of the genuine account. So this can be the identity theft. Then there are some other methods, like methods of stealing information. These are the theft to you can say threats to users, especially. First is identity theft, someone replacing your account using your account. And stealing information in form of shoulder surfing, in form of snagging, dumpster diving, social engineering, high technology methods. You know, like from shoulder surfing is actually generally someone when you are using some of your computer account or ATM machines, or if you are performing any of the transactions through online world, someone is behind you, maybe looking at you. So this may this is called shoulder surfing. When someone with you are inside with your in your company or somewhere in on the way, he looks at your system's screen or your mobile screen and takes the notice of your password and your user ID. Then is snagging. Sometimes you share your information on voice calls. So maybe someone hearing it, and when sometimes you are sharing the information to some of the reliable person, friend or family member, and the other one is they're looking at you and listening to you, and they take the information. Sometimes dumpster driving. Now when we take our stuff, rough stuff, to the dustbin. And if we have a huge company, and or sometimes we have some of the enemies looking at us, they take us these documents from the dustbin and rearrange, and they can see your account number or your some of the transactions with secret information. Then there is the social engineering. Now, social engineering is sometimes you use social networks where you use WhatsApp or your Facebook or some of the other social engineering tools that where you use to take share the information through the text, and the someone can decode that information and they can use it, misuse especially. High technology methods through the some of the softwares or some of the hackers, they can also enter into the system and enter the user accounts and are available online to steal your information. So these are the things that can be, there are threats to users, and some other threats to users are to privacy, users' privacy, identity theft through these methods, and then loss of privacy. So personal information is stored electronically, purchased or stored in databases. Databases is sold at other companies. Sometimes you make transactions through online, you purchase, sometimes you sell. But these are your interest, shows your interest. So some companies arrange the people's data according to their interest and show and sell it to the other company which may have the product according to their interest. So somehow they monitor your interest. So public records on the internet use is monitored and lost. None of these techniques are illegal. Sometimes these are not illegally, but they people arrange it and they use it. So internet monitoring, profiling, and spying is actually the common that can be made by the government agencies and also by the private organizations in order to see your interest. And as per your interest, they pop up their information into your online accounts so that you can be their customer. Cookies actually, when sometimes files are delivered from the websites, originally used to improve the site's function. When sometimes you open the website and they say we use cookies to save on your system so that you can see the more speed and we can trust on you. But cookies now sometimes track the history and password of your system. So this is, cookies can be dangerous. But if the organizations are worldwide standard and reliable, then there's no issue. But if sometimes you open the organization not sure about them to download their cookies and save their cookies on the system, that can be dangerous. So all these are the spywares. Sometimes the software we download from the computer, but they are actually designed or programmed to record your personal information and they send to their owner or their server. So this type of the spywares can be also dangerous, and there are many spywares available over the internet from the different people or organizations, just in order to notice the information on your local computer. Web bugs, sometimes the small programs are embedded into the GIF images that we download from the system or we use to open in the system when we especially use the internet. They get around cookies blocking tools, and companies use to track usage blocked with spyware class. So web bugs are also little programs they can be used to track your usage, what type of your usage inside the online systems. So this can also be blocked with spyware killers, but let's see spam. Now spam is unwanted, unsolicited commercial email that comes to your system. And now spam may take having some viruses, or spam may having some spyware so that they can use your data. So mostly spams are we used to have into the email account. We delete them directly. And sometimes spam looks like original, representing some of the organization. But they use it, some of the organizations, part of the header or logo, but they are actually not. So we need to remove the spam directly from the email or delete it. Now, these were the threats to users and threats to information. Now, threats to hardware. Uninterruptible power supply issues, line conditioners, surge suppressors, stabilizers, generators sometimes fail, needs to countermeasure the system, because sometimes power spikes and brownouts can create fluctuation in the power and they can damage our hardware. They can burn our hardware, some parts. So another thing is theft and vandalism. Thieves can steal your entire computer or they can damage your system. But we need to keep them in secure area, lock the computer's desk, do not eat near the computers, watch equipment, chase away adulterers, and handle equipment with the care. So these are the countermeasures. Natural disasters sometimes also can damage our hardware, like the fire, the earthquake. So these are the things. Recovery is to plan for recovery is to make servers or multiple records and place them at different places. Then there are most serious threat is the threat to the data, and data is actually the reason for existence of the computers. Data is very difficult to replace. Protection is difficult. Data is intangible. And some people make copy of the data, some people make your data the public, or sometimes they give some threats. So data is most important thing, and we need to make multiple copies and most secure to our data. Now, these are the things like the threats to data are through by the user, the viruses that actually change our data, they block our data, so damage our data, so that we cannot use our data. These are the viruses, and then we need to install on our computer the antivirus softwares, pop-up blockers, unknown emails we don't need to open in order to save ourselves from the viruses. So viruses are also the computer program that actually make control of our important data or our software so that we become unable to use them. So these are the actually the software that distributes their self, their multiple copies and itself, and they also install on our system automatically. In order to save ourselves from these, we need to install antivirus software. Then we have Trojan Horse. Trojan Horse is also the program that possesses a beneficial software. It looks like a beneficial software, but when we install it, it makes multiple copies of it, and it also damages our system. So countermeasures are also spyware, blockers, and antivirus softwares. Cybercrime, this is also the threat to data, is actually using computer in illegal act. Fraud and theft are common acts through cybercrimes. Nowadays, cybercrime is common, and illegal acts where someone uses the internet for the fraud. So fraudulent websites are also there, and they represent like legitimate sites, their names, they are fraud. And then there are the hacking. Using a computer to enter another network. So that can, hacking can be, whenever your computer is connected some of the network, wired or wireless, that is probably vulnerable to some hacking. So people can, the person with intention of hacking, can enter into your system and they can copy your data, they can damage your hardware, they can damage your software. And sometimes the hacking having three things, people use it for the recreational hacking, financial hackers, and grudge hacking. Now, recreational hacking is type of hacking that is done by the person for the entertainment purpose or for showing their efficiency and to their others. And they don't have any bad intention. But it's in order to show their efficiency that we can hack. Otherwise, the financial hackers, they actually hack the records of the companies doing business or the companies having some security data. They do this and they blame me for providing some financial in response to the opening in their system. So financial hackers, they sometimes hack bank accounts, or they sometimes hack the organization records, so they to break their organization. Garage hacking is actually someone having bad intention or having some problem, personal problem with some of the company or some of the person, so that they intentionally do it in order to threat the particular person or organization. So hacking methods are also sniffing, social engineering, and spoofing. But actually the hacker's motivation is recreational or financial or guns. Means their motivation sometimes because of the showing their efficiency, sometimes they need money, sometimes they have some enmity to the organization or person. But hacking methods are sniffing, social engineering, and spoofing. Now you see the hacking method sniffing. Finding user's password. For this, the password sharing, password guessing, password capture. So some for sniffing, sometimes we share information through social media or through the call, voice calls, or even in the verbal and physically, people may listen it, use it, misuse it. People, the person which is, sometimes we have friends in circle or colleagues in organization, they may guess our password because they are with us. Sometimes they capture our password through some of their system when we share it. Social engineering also is a type of the method for hacking when the they can capture our password through the last slide I told you that through the dumpster driving identity theft, phone survey cards, emergency situation, someone may sometimes for survey we receive some email in some emergency situation, we may tell someone may follow us. So social engineering online or in the real world people can guess our passwords and data information. Then there is spoofing. Spoofing is a alter, hackers may alter an email header to make it appear as a request from the information from the other. So sometimes they alter the header of the email, looks like original email from your the organization you are related or the organization you are stressed. You may respond them like financial, banking, or from their organization or from your education. So they actually know this information about you. So these were the things we will